name's Bishop Gorman.
I'm Jana Sayson.
And I'm Michael Delmont.
And Delmont, you're bringing a Christmas tree.
Yeah, because it's 1 week before Christmas break and I gotta put all my Christmas outfits to use. How do I look?
Pretty great.
And you know who else is great? God. And let us always remember that. So please stand because we're gonna pray.
Remember that we're in God's holy presence. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Dear God, too many times in today's world, people are afraid to say Merry Christmas. Help us to remember that we wouldn't have a holiday season if you did not love us so much that you sent us Jesus. As the world encourages us to use the word holiday so we don't offend anyone, give us the strength and the grace to be proud of what the holiday is, the birth of your Son, Jesus, and to wish others a Merry Christmas. Glory be to God in all things.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Now for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Bishop Gorman, are you ready for the best Christmas week ever?
Because BGTV is coming at you.
In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Bishop Gorman. I'm Kellie Stewart.
And I'm Patrick Black.
And this is BGTV. It's Monday, December 17, 2012, and also the start of your final week before break.
If you have forgotten why we are taking the next 2 weeks off, or why everyone is wearing festive colors today, there will be a Christmas assembly this afternoon to help you remember. Be ready to show off your holiday spirit.
And while we are talking about holiday spirit, remember that all this week we have different dress-up days. Tomorrow is Tree Topper Tuesday, Wednesday is Tacky Sweater Day, Thursday is Snow Day Attire, and Friday you get to be Santa or one of his elves. I'm sure we'll see lots of tremendous outfits.
It sounds like we're going to have a lot of fun this week. And of course, what would be a fun week at Gorman without block days? For the last time this year, there will be block days this Tuesday and Wednesday. Maybe the world really is ending this week.
Junior Block Wednesday, Bishop Gorman will be holding a returning student panel during study hall and lunch. Several alumni will be returning to answer your questions about their college experience. You can sign up on Naviance under the college visits page. If you have any questions, see Mr. McAllister.
I wonder if any of the Gales alumni go to UNR. On Thursday, a University of Nevada, Reno representative will be on campus for individual interviews. If you want to be a part of the Wolfpack in the future, hurry to see Mrs. Burford in Student Services. These spots are limited and are on a first-come, first-served basis.
Speaking of colleges, seniors, the deadlines for your college applications are fast approaching. December 31st, January 1st, and January 5th are common deadline dates for colleges. Bishop Gorman faculty will be off campus from December 20th to January 7th, so if these are your deadlines and you have any transcript requests, be sure to get them in ASAP.
And if you plan to go to college for a major in foreign language, specifically Spanish, you probably are in the National Spanish Honor Society. There's a short meeting today after school in room 107. Be sure to get there on time or it's hasta la vista for you.
If you participate or are interested in the Creative Writing Club, you may want to know about one last meeting before break. The club will meet at 6:30 a.m. on Friday in room 203. Make sure to bring copies of your work to read. And while we're talking about great writing, we would also like to give a shout out to over 50 of our own Gales who participated in the Scholastic Writing Competition.
The weather is getting colder, but the Gales winter sports are burning up. Here's Caitlin with the latest.
Thanks, Patrick. We had another short week in sports, but not any short of wins. The men's basketball rally passed Mountain View, Arizona to claim the to claim the crown with a 45-35 victory. They won all four games at the Wild West Shootout in Reno this past week and are currently 5-0 in the standings. You can check out the men and women tonight at Cimarron Memorial. The women play at 5 and the men at 6:30. The men's wrestling team kicks off their season tomorrow here at home against Legacy at 7 p.m. You better get out here, G-Block, because this opening match you won't want to miss. And last but certainly not least, congratulations to the Lady Gales bowling team. They won last week against Bonanza and Legacy. Come support the men and women tonight at 3:30 at South Point against Desert Oasis. That's it for sports. Back to you.
Thanks, Caitlin. You may have remembered when we hear Bishop Gorman held a miracle minute to raise money for Nick Andrade and his family to fly back home after a tragic diving accident in Brazil. We raised enough money to gain attention from the same NBC affiliate we ran the story from. Here's what happened.
All right, well, this is a story that has really captured our hearts. A Charlotte teenager paralyzed after diving into a river in Brazil. You probably remember this. Well, he needed $70,000 for an air ambulance to make it home.
Yeah, now we were the first to show you how Nick Andrade's friends came through. Today, another group of teenagers is going to pitch in. NBC Charlotte reporter Ann Sheridan joins us live at Charlotte Catholic High School, where Nick graduated just last year. Good morning, Ann.
Good morning. Nick Andrade's friends and family here at Charlotte Catholic got together and raised money to help get him home. But this morning, thousands of miles away in Las Vegas, Nevada, another school responds.
Ready to fade up to three?
They are miles from Charlotte.
Play, dissolve the fourth.
At Bishop Gorman High School in Las Vegas, Nevada.
At this time, we'd like to show you the story that ran on Charlotte's NBC affiliate.
But they saw our story on former Charlotte Catholic swimmer Nick Andrade and wanted to help.
Suzanne Albertson's chemistry class at Charlotte Catholic starts like many.
Broadcast media students set it up.
That the Lord helps us spare all things.
So the entire school could watch and follow Nick Andrade's journey.
We're very happy to report that 2 days ago, thanks to the generous contributions of those who saw that piece, Nick and his mom flew back to Charlotte and are now home.
Then more kids got involved.
Thank you.
The whole school, 1,250 students, decided to do something.
So we at Bishop Gorman are going to help. Tomorrow, during first period, instead of our usual mind box, we will be holding what we call a miracle minute.
Nick Andrade needs miracles. He remains paralyzed from the neck down. While the family once lived in Las Vegas, no one expected students, strangers from across the country, to care.
All it takes a little bit, whatever you got in your pocket tomorrow.
First, they sign cards, posters, notes.
Okay, here we go, miracle minute.
Then, for 60 seconds, they gave.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Good job. Good job.
Students with heart.
Okay, we're on our final 10 seconds.
Raising money for another student they don't even know. A miracle minute. What a great idea. Now, I did talk to a teacher at Bishop Gorman. Those students raised more than $4,000 for Nick Andrade. And this morning, Nick Andrade remains in Carolina's Medical Center. He is undergoing rehab and very hopeful that the doctors there can help him. Reporting live, Ann Sheridan, NBC Charlotte.
All right. Thanks a lot, Ann. And wow, Kellie, what a great story.
It's just amazing because these people really across the country heard this story and it really inspired them. It just shows even a small group of people can make such a big impact. $4,000, that's huge for this family.
Yeah, I suppose it's going to be a long road for him, so good for them helping Nick along the way.
And while we are all excited for Christmas Day, let us remember many families in Newtown, Connecticut will wake up to unopened presents. Please stand as we remember everybody affected in this massacre. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, we never realize how precious life really is and how many of the moments we take for granted. Please remind us how blessed and appreciative we are for our own families. We pray to you to watch over the families that suffered from this tragedy and give them strength this Christmas season. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.